Hi everyone, it's Sharon Nicole again. Today is day four of my recovery from my Rhino-Septo Revision. Just to recap real quick, this is my third surgery. The two previous surgeries did not turn out well and they were actually very botched, which is why I had to have my nose completely reconstructed this time and several things fixed about it, and hopefully it comes out fabulous. And I'm rocking unicorn rainbow colors on my eyes, but if you see my previous videos, they were a lot worse before. So now it's just a light pink, and it's starting to dissipate, but I am getting those awesome chipmunk cheeks. That is something that's common. I even got them in the first surgery when I had my cast off. All the bruising had gone away, but I did have chipmunk cheek swelling as everything was gravitating downwards for at least a couple days as far as I can remember. So I'm not sure how long this will be, but you're along on this journey with me, so we'll find out together. The pain is less today. However, I do have this burning sensation in my nose, which I think is just the pain changing over. If you've ever sprayed a nasal spray in your nose that has a burning sensation, that's kind of what I'm feeling. I'm still taking my pain meds, but just in small doses. I take a half of a dose every 2 hours, because it's one dose every 4 hours, or two doses every 6 hours. So I've actually broken that down since I metabolize it pretty fast. I'm gonna take half a dose every 2 hours, but please don't go by my advice. Talk to your doctor about it. Of course, this is just what works for me and what I worked out with my doctor. It's definitely easier to get around. I don't have any dizziness or anything. You may want to invest in some Metamucil or some type of laxative at this point, because it might be difficult after all the anesthesia and especially the pain meds, since that does cause some problems. Just being completely truthful and honest with you. My gums and teeth are still sore, but a little bit less. This is sore and I can feel where the splints are in, just why my nose is so wide, because it's actually being spread out by the splints in addition to being extremely swollen. This is still extremely swollen, although it has gone down a tiny bit. And my eyes do feel a little raw. So I think the blood coming to the surface makes my skin a little bit more sensitive. I've used Neosporin on them just to help, because Neosporin has numbing in it, so to help with some of the pain, but I just don't want to rub it too much. Just always use your ring finger when you're working under your eyes for any reason at all, because it's your weakest finger. That's why they say in cosmetics and cosmetology to always use your ring finger around your eye, because it pulls the least. I was able to wash my hair today. It was fabulous. I've had it in a scrunchie, so it's not... And I've been laying around, so it doesn't look great, but it was very nice. However, after the shower, I was exhausted just because I've been very weak and resting a lot. So the act of showering and trying to hold my hands up and keep my head back, because you can't get any of this wet, was a little tiring. So just make sure if you shower, have everything set up on the opposite side of the shower outside of the water. And if you have a detachable shower head, that works the best. If not, tilt it downwards so it's not spraying at you at all, and you can control yourself a little bit better, and just be very slow about it. And I do have, if you remember, I do have stitches behind my ear back here from where they took some fascia. And I was allowed to rinse over them today. I do use all Aveda products though, because it's natural, organic, and it makes my hair and skin amazing, of course, so shout out to Aveda. So there was no chemicals in it that would get into my stitches either. And other than that, I just stay moisturized. I still keep my chapstick on me, drink lots of water, still drinking my bone broth. I can eat a little bit more today and a little bit better. So I did make some egg whites, but I still don't have any smell or any taste. which kind of is an appetite killer. But all in all, I am starting to feel better. I even went outside in the sun for a little bit today. I took the trash out, which just to get outside was fantastic. Me and my kitten even went out on the porch. I mean, when you're here in sunny Southern California, especially during May gray, and you get really nice sunny days, you want to take advantage of them. But it's also healthy for you too. You should get at least 20 minutes of direct sunlight on you every morning, because your brain needs that, and your body also helps generate vitamin D from that. But since you're indoors a lot, do increase your vitamin D. I would highly recommend that. Confirm that with your doctor, of course, but would definitely increase your vitamin D, because that's going to help a lot with your immune system, your mood, and just your overall health, since you're not getting as much sun. But of course, if you're also in places where you don't get enough sun, you should do that anyhow. We're definitely deficient in this country in vitamin D, so just keep up with your vitamins, and your nourishment. Drink lots of water, and should still relax, but it is starting to get better now, and it's only day 4. So I hope that's a little bit more encouragement to you. It's definitely encouragement to me. Other than my unicorn eye makeup here and my chipmunk cheeks, it's not too bad. All that will go away, so it should be all worth it. So I will come back again tomorrow for day 5, and thanks for hanging in here with me, and I hope anything I'm giving you and the information I'm showing you is helpful. And I'll see you tomorrow. Bye.